Today we're going to install a 50-inch radius bar on our 2012 Ram. We're going to go over what's going to come included in your kit and how to get it installed. We have a 50-inch radius bar from Bulldog LED Lights. It's going to come with your light bar, your wiring harness, switches, fuses, the side mount for your light bar, and the roof mounts. We're going to go ahead showing you how to get it wired up and installed. We have a 50-inch radius bar. We have a wire lead that comes off the back with your connector. You have your wiring harness with your relay on it. You're going to have positive with a fuse that's going to go to your battery, and your negative. You're also going to have the wire that's going to come off and go to your light bar. When you get it installed, all you're going to have to do is plug it right into your light bar. Now, you have plenty of wire coming off of your relay harness. This you're going to run into the cab of your vehicle so that you can mount it to your switch. This is a power wire and a trigger wire for your relay. When you get your wires ran into the cab of your vehicle, you're going to have your switch and then a small wire. This wire is going to go to ground. This is going to illuminate the light on your switch so that you know when your light bar is on. You're also going to have two fuses. You're going to have a 15 amp fuse, which is going to be for a 20 inch light bar and smaller, and a 30 amp fuse, that's going to be for a 30 inch light bar and larger. To mount your 50 inch radius bar, there's two screws on the side of your light bar. You're going to remove those. You're going to use the side mounts. Take the two bolts, slide them in. And then there's two new screws that you're going to use for your side mount. This is the side mount. This is what's going to mount to the brackets on the roof of your truck. Do not remove any of the other screws or the end cap. Also, on this vehicle, our side mount, you're going to want to make sure that the larger end is in the back because it is tapered. To get our 50-inch radius bar installed, we have to install the roof mounts. You're going to come with two mounts, driver and passenger, gasket that's going to go on, your hardware. There's going to be these rivet nuts that you have to install. So you're going to want to measure and mark the holes for your brackets, and then drill the holes to put these inserts in. We're going to go ahead and get that started, and we'll show you how to put these in. To put the brackets on our roof, you're going to put the brackets up there and mark the holes. You're going to use an 1/8-inch drill bit to start, and then a 25/64 for the nut insert. To put the inserts in, if you don't have a nut cert tool, you can use this. What you're going to do is you're going to put a little bit of silicone around the nut cert when you put it in. You're going to have the bolt and then two larger nuts. Slide it through the nuts, thread it in the insert. Put the insert into your vehicle and then hold the two nuts with a wrench and crank down on it. You're going to want to crank it down till this smashes inside. Back it out. Then you'll be okay. We're going to show you how to do this on the vehicle. Okay, put a little bit of silicone around the insert. Put it in your hole. Make sure it's flush with the top of the vehicle. And then crank it down. Okay, we have the holes drilled and we have the inserts in. The next thing to do is to mount the passenger side bracket. You're going to take the rubber gasket that they came with. You're going to put that down first. Then you're going to take your bracket for the passenger side, sit that up, and then hardware. Okay, we got our light bar up here. We already mounted our passenger side to the vehicle. So you're going to take your light bar, slide it on the passenger side, and mount it to the bracket. We're going to take the bracket and already have it mounted to our light bar on the driver's side. Then you're going to take your bracket, bring it down, and mount your bracket to the vehicle. If you already have your brackets mounted to the vehicle, you might not have enough room to slide your bracket in, to slide your light bar into the bracket. We have our light bar mounted up with our mounts on our roof, but the trim piece here that we had to peel up to pull our mount down needs to be trimmed back. She's just going to push it back down until it gets to the end of the mount and then trim it off right there. Now you're done. You can go ahead and get started on the wiring harness and the relays for the light bar. You got your light bar mounted up on the roof with the roof mounts. You still have to run your wiring harness with the relay. Take your relay harness. We're going to mount our relay harness next to our battery. That way we can get our positive and negatives connected. So we found a nice spot right here next to the battery. We're going to mount it. And then you're going to want to take the wires and run them up to the light bar and plug those in. After that, you're going to run the trigger wire into the cab to your switch. We ran our trigger wire for our relay into our cab. You're going to want to find somewhere to mount your switch inside your cab on the dash somewhere. Once you've mounted it, you can plug the wires into the back of your switch. You also have one short wire. This is a ground wire. You're going to connect this to the back of your switch and then to a ground. That's going to allow the LED on your switch to illuminate. Okay, the last part of running our relay harness, which we mounted up here by our battery, is to run the wire to our LED light bar. Now we ran that wire up here along the battery and then right up here and up this channel along our window. This piece right here just pulls off. There's a couple clips underneath of it. Once we pulled that off, there was enough room behind here to run our wire right up here along our window and bring it out right here to plug it in at our light bar. Got that pushed back down in, sealed nice, and it looks nice and clean. All you have to do, go ahead and plug that harness right into your light bar. Then you're going to want to tuck it back here behind the bracket and secure it up out of the way. Then you can go ahead and turn your light bar on after you've installed the 30 amp fuse. Okay, we have our light bar hooked up to our relay harness. We put our 30 amp fuse in and all of our wires are tied up out of the way. Now we're going to go ahead and turn our light bar on so we can see how bright it is and make sure everything works right. Now that you know your light bar works, you can go ahead and loosen these up if you need to. Turn your light bar on so you can tilt it and position it to where you would like.